Dear students, today I will start a series of lectures on ring frame. In today's lecture, my topic is construction of spindle. In this first diagram, I will explain you the path of the thread after drafting ruler. The material delivered from front roller nip passes through this thread guide and then balloon control ring. This thread guide is positioned directly over the spindle, which keeps the yarn into the center of the spindle, and this balloon control ring controls the size of the balloon. After balloon control ring, the yarn passes through combination of ring and traveler, and winding on the bobbin takes place. Winding on the bobbin on the spindle itself arises from interplay between the speed of the traveler rotating on the ring and the rotational speed of the spindle. The latter is therefore the third most important machine element, following the drafting arrangement and the ring and traveler combination. This was about the thread path. Now the construction of spindle. The spindle can be divided into two parts. The first one is shaft and second one is bolster. As we see in this diagram, the spindle can be divided into two parts. This one is upper part, which is spindle blade, and this one is second part, which is bolster. Other parts are neck bearing and footstep bearing, then spindle valve. This one is spindle blade and chamber, then damping device, flexible tube, bolster and spiral spring and a slot. The spindle consists of two clearly separate parts, namely upper part or spindle blade and the bolster. The upper part is made up of aluminium alloy and slightly tapered. Near its upper end, it has a tube gripping device that ensures firm setting of tube on the upper part. The lower end of the upper part or spindle blade terminates in the valve, which is bell shaped or slightly curved so that it can be placed over the neck bearing. This combination of bell shaped valve and neck bearing causes smooth running of the spindle. Now the bolster is fixed to the ring rail by means of a nut. The lower part comprises of a bolster, which is made up of either cast iron or steel, a chamber. This chamber is provided to hold lubricating oils, a fixed neck bearing, a flexible foot bearing, spindle damping device, and a spiral spring for supporting the foot step bearing to take up impacts transferred from the blade, and a flexible tube connection between the upper and the lower bearing. The footstep bearing usually has slots through which oil can circulate, mainly when the spindle is subjected to shocks. This circulation can wash out the metal particles. The chamber between the blade and the bolster is filled with lubricating oil, which must be changed or replaced after 10 to 20,000 operating hours. This is about the construction of spindle. Thank you.